history has just been made. The New York Knicks are the first 8th seed to ever make the NBA Finals.
I kind of remember, I think it was 20 games or 16. And all we said was one game at a time. Give ourselves a chance because we can catch who was in front of us. I'm not sure if it was Detroit or somebody. And we got a little healthier. And then collectively, we're able to finally, you know, put our egos aside and everybody say, you know what? We don't care who leads us in scoring, who leads in rebounds. The main thing is to get a W. And I think we won like 11 out of 16 or something like that. And all we want to do is get in. We get in, we got a chance to beat anybody.
Who would you say was the glue guy of that 9-9 squad? Who's the guy that really brought you guys together in the face of adversity and through the tough times?
Quite honestly, you know, normally you would pick a player and I would put LJ in that era, but Jeff Van Gundy. You know what I mean? He would, as a coach, I have the utmost respect for him because he wouldn't let us give in to feeling sorry for ourselves. You know, and we seen how hard he worked and how hard he studied and to get us prepared. It wasn't anything that he did wrong. All he can do is give us the game plan.
Right.
And we got to go out there and execute. We weren't. So I think he was the glue to keep us focused, to keep us, you know, in tune to that all we got to do is win one game. In the next game, we win the next game and just keep building that way. And with him still having confidence in us as players and as a team, we'll hopefully get ourselves focused again and go out there and make things happen.
Well, we did struggle, you know, during the course of the year. Because of the lockout year, we didn't have time to gel. And as you mentioned, we did have, you know, injuries because we were playing a lot of games back to back. There were some games, some weeks we were playing three games in a row to try to make up to get to a certain number, which I think was 50 at the time. And so, you know, we had a lot of things that we had to navigate through. And as you mentioned, Coach Van Gundy's job was on the line. All of our jobs were on the line and in some form or fashion. And also being in New York, your job's always on the line.
Yep.
That's just part of, you know, being in New York. But, you know, the good thing was, you know, we had some good foundational pieces. We had some good talent. We knew that if we could ever get healthy or get everyone back playing, that we had a chance. And I think that's what happened. We started to catch our stride late in the season. And we were able to run off, you know, when we needed to run off, you know, get on a run to make it to the playoffs. We were able to do that. But, you know, just like anything that has some success at the end of the rainbow, there's always going to be those times where doubt comes in from the outside, and internally we have to stick together. There's going to be times that's going to, you know, we have to persevere through, you know, the challenges. And we can't listen, you know, we couldn't listen to the outside noise because that would only throw us back even further. And so we just found a way to bond and come together as one team and be able to overcome all the negativity that was on the outside. And we used to have meetings and team meetings and player-only meetings. We had quite a few of those during the time. But, you know, when it's all said and done, you know, when you're out there on the court, guys got to be bought into the process. And I think, you know, we had enough veteran guys and guys willing to, you know, play as one unit that we were able to overcome, you know, the negativity.